Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi arrived in India in the year 1915. He was already active against the British in South Africa, where he practiced law for a few years. He decided that to be more active and have a greater impact, he needed to feel the pulse of the people of India. In India, his greatest achievement was to bring people of all ages, castes, religions, etc. together under his leadership. In Gandhi, India found a leader who was like them and who understood them. His path of non-violent struggle against the British only strengthened his cause. Gandhi planned many of the major peaceful agitations against the British. Neither the British nor the people of India ever thought such an approach of non-violence could have had such an impact on the general psyche of a nation. In 1919, the British, having sensed a growing sense of unrest in present-day Punjab, ordered that it was illegal to unite or form groups of more than three people. The message, however, was slow and did not reach the masses, who at that time had already planned for a peaceful protest that evening in the lawns of Jallianwala Bagh. The British head police, having heard of the meeting, decided to go to the grounds and teach them a lesson. The police entered into the bagh as the meeting was already in session, and with no warning the soldiers were ordered to open fire upon the innocent people who had gathered there. Men, women and children were ruthlessly killed. People had nowhere to go. This incident marked the rise of armed rebellion against the British. Many people were involved in the freedom struggle. Although majority of the movements were peaceful, some indulged in extreme use of violence to spread their cause for freedom.
Some amongst them included legends and martyrs such as Bhagat Singh, Chandrashekhar Azad, Rajguru, Sukhdev and others.
These people now called for complete independence. They wanted British to leave the country and to leave now. And if not, they would go to any extremes to get India its independence.
The Quit India movement was the last major agitational movement in India. Britain's long involvement in the World War weakened its already depleted resources. Use of Indian soldiers in the World War was another major concern for Indian leaders. India's leaders argued that Britain had to stop using Indians for their imperialistic ambitions. With the British government agreeing to certain conditions put forward by the Indian leaders, the movement came to an end in the year 1943. With the hope of overthrowing British power in India, some leaders, notably Subash Chandra Bose, started the Indian National Army or Azad Hind Fauj. His idea was that for India to gain complete independence, India needed to take up arms. The Indian National Army was involved in a battle in the northeastern states of India in the final years of the World War. Although the Indian National Army's stand was in great contrast to the ideas of Mahatma Gandhi, many leaders felt that India as a nation needed to have a standing army to protect its natural boundaries.
Long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny, and now the time comes when we shall redeem our pledge. At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom.